In this illustration, I will analyze a vertically floating glass tube. We are given that a thin walled glass tube has diameter 4 cm and weighs 30 gram. And the center mass of the tube is at a distance 10 cm above the bottom. We are required to find the amount of water which must be poured in the tube so that it can vertically float in a water tank. Here, in this situation, we need to understand a body can float vertically in water tank only when its center of gravity is below the center of buoyancy in the submerged part of body. Like for example here, if we wish this tube to float vertically in water, then in this situation we'll consider liquid is filled in it to a height say y. And if we consider x is the total depth which is submerged in it, then the buoyancy force will act at a point which we call center of buoyancy is at the center of the submerged part, which is x by 2. So the center mass of this tube plus the water inside must coincide or will be below the point x by 2. Otherwise, the tube will become horizontal due to the torque applied by buoyancy force and the force of gravity. So in this situation here we can say, if water is poured up to a level y in tube, which we can see I've drawn in the figure, and x is the submerged length of tube. Here we can use for equilibrium of tube. Here we can write the weight of tube is 30 grams, so we can solve it in CGS units also. This will be 30 plus if A is the cross sectional area of the tube. The mass of water in it will be A y rho, and this must be equals to the mass of water displaced by this tube, that will be ax rho, and this gives us the value of x is equals to 30 plus ay divided by a. And in the situation for vertical flotation of tube, we must use the center of mass of tube plus water should be equals to the center of buoyancy. Here we are talking about the height of center of mass of tube plus water is equals to height of center of buoyancy. So with the bottom, if we calculate, this center of buoyancy is located at a distance of x by 2. And if we calculate the center of mass of tube plus water, this can be given by the expression m1 x1 plus m2 x2 upon m1 plus m2. So this will write as 30 multiplied by 10 plus ay rho multiplied by y by 2 divided by the total mass is 30 plus ay rho. And we can also substitute the value of x over here, which is 30 plus ay divided by 2a. So simplifying this relation it gives, we can also cross multiply it. Here we can consider water density to be 1 in CGS. So this 30 plus ay whole square divided by 2a is equals to 300 plus ay square by 2. If we simplify this relation, here it gives the value of y, which is 10 minus 15 by a. I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to simplify this equation and verify. The value of y we'll be getting is 10 minus 15 by a. And from here, we are given that the glass tube has a diameter 4 centimeter, then we can now write mass of water poured in the tube is equals to Ay, rho we can take as 1 as we are solving the problem in CGS. This can be written as A multiplied by 10 minus 15 by A. So this mass of water we are getting is 10 A minus 15, and the value of A we can use as pi r square, and the radius we can take as 2 centimeter. So this will be 10 multiplied by this pi multiplied by 2 square minus 15. If you numerically solve it, this gives us 40 pi minus 15, which is equals to 110.6 gram. That is the answer for this problem.